Today's topic is expected value, rolling 2 6-sided number cubes. Let us read the problem. Suppose you play a game with 2 6-sided number cubes. If you roll a sum of 5 or 8, you win $20. If you roll a sum divisible by 6, you win $12. However, you lose $15 for anything else. How much do you expect to win or lose per roll in the long run? A 6-sided number cube has sides labeled 1 through 6. Let us say these are the numbers in the first number cube, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And these are the numbers in the second number cube, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If the 2 6-sided number cubes are rolled simultaneously, there are 36 possible outcomes. Some of the possible outcomes are 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. Let us add the numbers in each pair of outcomes. In this table, the numbers in the first row are the numbers in the first number cube, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The numbers in the first column are the numbers in the second number cube, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The numbers between the first row and the first column are the outcomes. Each is a sum of the numbers in its pair. For example, 1 plus 1, 2. 1 plus 2, 3. 1 plus 3, 4. 1 plus 4, 5. 1 plus 5, 6. 1 plus 6, 7. Construct a table with 4 columns. In the first column, write the word sum. In the second column, write the lowercase letter x. In the third column, write p of x. In the fourth column, write x times p of x. Our first sum is 5 or 8. According to the problem, if you roll a sum of 5 or 8, you win $20. So $20 is the first value of x. Let us count the sums of 5 or 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There are 9 of them. So the probability of winning $20 is 9 out of 36 because there are 36 outcomes. Multiply 20 by 9 over 36. The product is $5. The next sum is divisible by 6. According to the problem, if you roll a sum divisible by 6, you win $12. So $12 is the second value of x. Let us count the sums divisible by 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 of them. So the probability of winning $12 is 6 out of 36. Multiply $12 by 6 over 36. The product is $2. Next, anything else? According to the problem, you lose $15 for anything else. So the third value of x is negative $15. Negative because you are going to lose $15 for anything else. Let us count all these sums. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So 21 over 36. Multiply negative $15 by 21 over 36. The product is negative 8.75. Add this algebraically. Sigma x times p of x is equal to negative $1.75. This means there is a loss per roll in the long run of $1.75.